Hi, this is Coach David Halal. Today we're gonna do a special video to speak on a few great men that lived, that conquered and accomplished greatness. You see, it's in us to conquer. It's in us to win. It's in us to achieve. It's in us to create. In fact, for some, it's an obsession. Some of the greats, like Julius Caesar, Alexander the Great, or Solomon, King David, so many great emperors in Africa, so many great emperors in Europe, in Asia. These men achieve greatness. Toussaint Louverture from Haiti, Spartacus, and different people that fought to win and to achieve and to get the freedom that we were all born to be or to have. To live the freedom that the creator of the universe has given us. When you are a great man or a great woman, it is very important for you to study these things about these people. You see, one of my obsessions is with the Roman Empire, the Greek mythology and Greece, the country, you know, what they have achieved, such a small country, have achieved such greatness. England, you know, some people might agree, some people might disagree, but they have accomplished things that it's mind-boggling. It's very important to make ourselves as great as we can be, like the great Muhammad Ali said. I'm gonna show you how great I am. My friends, names are so important. They create mental pictures. When you hear someone speak the name of Thomas Edison, you think of inventions, don't you? Certainly the name Henry Ford reminds you of automobiles. The Wright brothers reminds you of airplanes. When the name Alexander the Great, when his name is spoken, people think immediately of a great conqueror, a great man who did not live long. He died in his 30s, but accomplished greatness. When people hear the name Solomon, people think immediately of wisdom. Why? Because wisdom was the obsession and goal of his life. Alexander the Great achieved such greatness that Julius Caesar went to see him, to see his statue. And when he got there, to see that this guy at 31, 32 years old achieved such greatness, history said that Julius Caesar wept. He said, I have to accomplish great things also. It is very important for us to achieve greatness. A lot of people are talking about depression, but that depression comes from, a lot of times, from the lack of achievement, the things that they want to achieve that was not, or that has not been possible. You see? Another great thing about a great man named Solomon, he cultivated such self-confidence that he could achieve his dream. Self-confidence, my friends, creates a climate. Those around you can sense the invisible currents of purpose within you. Your thoughts have presence. The atmosphere, my friends, that you permit determines the product you produce. Self-confidence creates a miraculous climate. Alexander the Great was so self-confident, was so hungry also to achieve greatness, that after, it is said, right there in that picture that I have there, of course, it's not really Alexander the Great, but it's a picture that depicts the greatness, the great fighters, the great warriors back in the days, you know. He got there and he stood and saw that the rest of Asia has been conquered, and he wept. He wept because he could not continue. There was no more land possible for him to conquer. So it's very important for us to understand that hunger you have in you to do crazy things, it's not really for you to achieve, to do bad things, or to kill, or to do things that are illegal. It's really the hunger that's in you, that's pushing you, the passion, the fuel, if you will, to achieve greatness. I am so into these studies and these history of greatness, of great men and great women, that I remember buying a book that talks about Rome and talks about the Greek mythology, talk about Achilles, you know, and the Empire of Troy, you know. I bought this book for over $400 a while ago. And that book, so far, that when I'm reading it, I can sit there for hours and reading it. It also has great pictures that I can look and see, you know, these, you know, guys on horses, on, you know, chariots, you know, achieving greatness, going as far as, you know, across the globe to kill and to achieve and to conquer and to create. You see, that is important. You cannot achieve greatness if you don't have the passion and the goal to suffer, because you have to understand you will suffer trying to achieve, trying to bring your family the way you want, trying to bring up your business to the level of success that you desire. There are 7 steps that I will talk quickly that can unlock your self-confidence. The first one, recognize that the universe wants good things to happen for you, or source wants good things to happen for you. The creator wants good things to happen for you. Make certain that your dream, that's number two. Number two, make certain that your dream is not contrary to the laws of the universe or man. Number three, fill every conversation with faith and talk about your dream. Do not allow people to kill your dream. Do not allow people to minimize your dream. Associate, number four, associate often with those whose fire is presently burning brighter than your own. You see, in order for you to achieve greatness, you're gonna have to be around people that have achieved greater things than you. You cannot be with people that have never achieved anything, or people that are limited, or people that have no desire to achieve. You can't be hanging around with bums trying to achieve greatness. Number five, remember your own dream is a special seed, my friend, that you are sowing into the hearts of others. Sometimes these people will be excited and thrilled with you. However, there will be times when those closest to you are not ready to receive. A farmer knows his field requires preparation before he plants his seed. Likewise, the minds and hearts of those you love may require preparation as well. You must be patient. Number six, remember that your dream may intimidate those closest to you and make them feel uncomfortable. You know, a lot of times when I talk about the things I want to achieve, I see people, you know, friends and families, you know, I can see in their faces, they thinking, who the hell you think you are? I am that I am. That's what I always tell them. Number seven to finish, it's keep your fire fueled. You can only keep your fire fueled, my friends, if you take the time to fertilize your own dreams. Talk about them, build on them, study them. Study people that have achieved that kind of dream that you want to achieve. Cover your walls with photographs and posters to help you visualize your dreams. You can't expect to light somebody else's fire until you have lit the fire within you. What is your biggest dream at this moment? Are you willing to devote all your time and attention to it? Are you willing to create a plan that will make it happen? You see, the most wonderful thing that can happen to a dream is a specific plan of action. It births self-confidence. You must write it down. Write it down. Make it plain. And let it be known that you will accomplish greatness. Now, to finish this video quickly, I want to stop here at 10, 11 minutes. But understand that your dream will require a lot of suffering. This is Coach David Halal, fearlessly and passionately pursuing his call and his destiny. Be a man, be a woman of great achievement. Talk to you later. Don't forget to subscribe, like my videos. I'll talk to you again.